psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let's go to the house of the Lord. And it's our prayer that you're glad that you're here. We want to tell you, we're glad that you're here. And this Sunday, we are celebrating not only Holy Communion, but also All Saints Sunday. And we'll be sharing in that service in just a little bit. I know we have some guests with us this morning. We welcome you to First United Methodist Church. And our children are with us, and we're glad to have them in for this service of communion and All Saints celebration. We've got some beautiful flowers here just behind me to my right. They're placed here to honor Pam Posey. Where is Pam? Hey, Pam. And they're placed here in honor of your anniversary by your beloved husband, David. Happy anniversary. And that's nice, and we appreciate y'all sharing the flowers with us. This is also first Sunday in November. So, Paul, we need a happy birthday time. So if you have a November birthday, would you please stand so we can sing happy birthday to you?
Oh, my goodness. Miss Betty.
Look at all these birthdays.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
That stood up and then sat down, so I'm not sure whether he is trying to remember if his birthday really is in November, but if it is, happy birthday as well.
There's several things coming up that we need your attention on. One is this week, the seniors are taking a road trip to the Cove at Seashore Highlands. This is the new Methodist Senior Center located north of Gulfport. We need a head count to go, for they are providing lunch for us. So you can sign up in the narthex there or on your way out in the educational hall. But we do need you to sign up. Also, some of you have been asking about the special women's event coming up November 17th. We also need a sign up for this event because of books being ordered and so forth. There is a registration fee of $10, and that can be paid at the door. But for right now, we just need to know that you're coming so we can be ready. This is a special time for the ladies to gather after worship, and we'll meet in the gym for a dinner. And the dinner is being brought by each one of us as we bring a vintage dish or a traditional dish that's used in our family. And so during that time, there'll be a lot of reminiscing and reflecting on tradition, but also what Christmas means to us and our families. So come out for the fun and the fellowship. And there's a place in the narthex, again, to sign up for this event.
Two other things I want to share with you. First, church council meets tomorrow night at 6 o'clock in the activities room. We are looking and getting ready for our November 20th charge conference, and we'll be working, hopefully approving our budget for next year, so we need you there 6 o'clock. Also, Methodist Men Countywide is Thursday night, and I'm trying to remember where that is. That's at Safe Harbor on Highway 63. If you want to go by van, you'll meet us here by 5:30. We'll leave about a quarter till 6, and that's this Thursday. Anything else? Well, as I said, this is All Saints Sunday, and it's a time for us to remember, it's a time for us to celebrate the lives of the loved ones that our church family has lost over this past year. And family members are here to celebrate their life, their ministry, and their going home celebration as well. So as we participate in this time of worship, let's invite the Lord to be present with us. Let's pray together. Almighty God, your people of all the ages live and praise you without ceasing. Those here on earth and those in heaven. And in our communion with you this morning, we know that we have communion with generations past. Our grandparents, our parents, our great-grandparents, brothers and sisters who have gone on before us. And we also have communion with generations that are yet to be born. Because we know that in Christ Jesus we are all one, that we are family. And we know that there will come a time when you come to receive your church, when you will gather all of your family together, and what a day of celebration that will be. Lord, ask that you grant to your church here on earth that as we celebrate the triumph of your saints in glory, that we may profit from their example and their witness and enter with them into the inexpressible joys that you have prepared for all those who serve and love you. Come, Lord Jesus, for it's in the name of the Holy Spirit, you abiding with you, with us and your church. Lord, we make these prayers now in your name. Amen. Amen.
Now let's stand and join together in praising our God and King.
Thank you.
Apostles' Creed. The creed is about what we believe as God's family, as the Church of Jesus Christ. So if you will, join with me.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you. Be seated.
Grace to you, and peace from God who is, who was, and who is to come. And from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, the ruler of kings on earth, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with all the saints. Amen. Will you pray with me? O Lord, we come this morning blessing your holy name for all your servants who have finished their course, now rest from their labors. Grant us grace to follow the example of their steadfastness and their faithfulness to your honor and glory through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
This is All Saints Sunday. It's a day that the church all over the world, many of those churches will take time to remember those who have gone on to be with the Lord in heaven, those who have in our church family who have passed away over this past year. And we, the church, continue to pray for their families, the loved ones who are still grieving their loss. And we ask, as we pray for God's strength, we pray for God's comfort, and most of all, we pray that his love will abide not only in those that we are praying for, but also in all of our hearts as we give thanks for the life of those who we celebrate this morning. We're not celebrating their death. We're celebrating their life, their new life with Jesus Christ, a new life that began here. And they witnessed to that new life, they witnessed to their faith as they worked for the church, as they gave the support of the church's ministry, as they made a difference in so many people's lives and they touched so many hearts, especially ours. As we call out the names of these saints who have gone on to glory, if the family is here, we invite them to just stand where they are, and then we will conclude with a time of prayer. We remember Anna Morgan Brown, 12/23/2012.
Reverend Lamar Spencer, 3/12/13.
Mrs. Doris Crawford, March 19, 2013.
Francis Herala, March 21st, 2013.
Joe Tudor. March the 24th, 2013.
Jack Womack. April 1st, 2013.
Leslie Alice Bird. May the 14th, 2013.
Dorothy Lynn McElwain, September 21st, 2013.
Hermes Doshea Hay, September 28th, 2013. Let's pray. Almighty and everlasting God, this day revives in us memories of loved ones who are now in their heavenly home with you. What happiness we shared when they walked among us. What joy when loving and being loved, we live our lives together. Father, their memory is such a wonderful blessing to us and will be forever. And on this All Saints Day, we give thanks that they are now alive and they reign with you in heaven. As a great cloud of witnesses, they surround us with their blessings and they offer you their hymns of praise and thanksgiving. Lord, continue to surround all of these family members, these present, and these that could not be with us, these friends and this church family with your love and with your comfort and with your peace. We offer up these prayers as we remember these saints. And we offer these prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, B.C.
Let's stand and sing the following hymn, which reminds us that we are one in the body of Christ with those who have gone on before us. Let us rise.
Joy so the shore.
so we can share with you this morning. Church, but it's good to have you in Big People's Church too. This is your church, and today we're celebrating All Saints Sunday. Now that may be a new term. Hey, James, y'all come on. That may be a new term for you, but when the church speaks of saints, we speak of saints in two ways. Those who have gone on to be with Jesus in heaven, we call those loved ones saints. Can you say the word saint? Saints. They are saints. And then there are those of us who are still here. And we call some of us, we call us saints in the making. You're a saint in the making. Did you know that? Sometimes you might think, well, I wonder why I need to go to church. Yeah, he does. He does. And the reason that God wants you in church and the reason we want you in church is for you to know more about Jesus so that you will continue when you get old and gray like me. Yes, yes. That you'll continue to walk and that you will have an opportunity to tell other people about you. Right? Right. Now, you see all those folks out there? You don't know many of them. You know some of them. Some of those folks are your parents and some of them are your grandparents and some of them, the rest of them are your friends. A lot of these folks out here pray for you and your well-being every day because they want you to become a saint. I'm not talking about New Orleans saints. I'm talking about God's saints. People that make a difference because they love Jesus. Okay? And today, we're celebrating. And sometimes that's a little hard to understand how we can celebrate when our loved one is with Jesus. But the church has always done that. The church tells us that when we leave this earth and we go to heaven with Jesus, that we are so much better off. Because there's no more pain and no more sickness, no more disappointment, no more colds or whatever the case may be. Okay? And so today, we're remembering eight or nine in our church family that have passed away this last year. And that was a sad time for us. And it's still sad. Yeah. But we know that they're with you. And that's the most important thing. Okay? And here's what I want to tell you. That they're with Jesus, and guess who's here with us? Jesus. Okay? Jesus is right here. He's right here. And he's celebrating with us today. You're being here, and your process of becoming saints. Okay? So when you look at some of these folks out here, and they maybe are helping you, maybe teachers, parents, or other family members, grandparents, and they are helping you to be the saint that they know that Jesus wants you to be. They know that you can be themselves. You give thanks for them, okay? God put them here to help you. And he put you here to help us. Good. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for our children. We thank you for those who work with our children and teach our children, who love them. And we just pray, Lord, that we will be faithful in doing all that we can do to share you, Lord Jesus, with them. So that as they grow in stature, that they'll grow in wisdom, and they'll grow in their love of you. And again, Lord, we thank you for those who we have named before you this morning, who have gone on to be with you, and who shared their witness with us and so many, even some of these children. Lord, be with them. Bless them. We make this prayer in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you. You can go back and sit, and we'll see you in just a little bit when we celebrate communion, okay? We'll continue our worship through our giving of our tithes and offerings and gifts. Lord, this time of worship is not just about us putting money into the offering plate. It's an invitation to put ourselves and give ourselves to you and to your church. To use all the gifts that you've given us so that others might come to know you as Lord and Savior. Our gifts, Lord, are not just about you, but they're about other people. And we thank you for the faithfulness of the people here at First United Methodist, as their gifts are being used to share Jesus, both in the church and in the community and around the world. Father, bless these gifts, for this prayer is made in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Be seated. I talked to Sam Stewart early this morning. Her mother, Ms. Helen Ham, passed away early. Ms. Ham had Alzheimer's and was in Florida. We just need to remember Sam and all of her family, especially this week, and as they go through a time of loss and grief. And Sam told me this morning that her mom was so much better off. And we use that expression a lot of times. Sam and I would have conversations about our moms because they both have Alzheimer's and how difficult that is for children and grandchildren and families to have to go through. But we just invite you to remember Sam and all of her family in your prayers. Our prayer time this morning is going to be a little bit different. I want you to pray. And I call this a bidding prayer, things that you have on your heart and mind, things that maybe you've been a little reluctant to share to God. We sometimes forget, and ministers as well, that things that we're concerned about, sometimes they're way deep in the crevices of our hearts and in the really dark places in our hearts. Things that maybe we're battling, things that are pressing and depressing us, things that we just need to bring to light. Sometimes as we pray, we thank God for the many blessings that He has shed on us, and that's what we need to do as well. But this morning, I invite you, I will share some things, and if that touches a nerve for you, and you know the Holy Spirit's been working in your life in that particular area, we'll give you an opportunity to just open those areas up to the healing of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Lord, in the silence of this worship time, we just come to you. We come to you. Sometimes we come with joy in our hearts and thanksgiving. Sometimes our hearts are heavy. And they hurt because of the grief or pain that we're going through. Whatever, how we come, you're always ready to receive it. Always ready to hear those things that we need, that we want to share with you. And so hear our prayers this morning. For we are your family. We are the body of Christ. Yes, Lord, we're coming in just a minute to commune with you, but we want that communion to begin right now. So we're opening up our hearts and our minds, our souls, the very essence of who we are, to you right now. Lord, I know that there are people here whose hearts have been broken, who need to experience again your healing, who are grieving, who are hurting, who are lost. Lord, look deep into the presence of our hearts and whatever needs that we have. Lord, bring your healing touch into our lives and make us whole. though there may be people here this morning, your church, who've had a hard week, who are dealing with difficult times, whose feelings may have been hurt by a co-worker or family member. And they're just having a very difficult time giving that to you, forgiving, and asking for the grace to forgive those that have hurt them. Lord, we offer these prayer requests to you. Bring your grace into our lives and help us to forgive. Forgive ourselves when we have failed you, or forgive others who have failed us. Lord, we pray for strength in our spiritual journey with you. The times that you open the doors for us to witness to our faith and to your saving grace, and we fail to do that. Lord, I pray that if anyone is here this morning and they have been down that road this week, or the weeks past, that you would just give us the opportunity to share our faith once again. We know that that will be a blessing to us, but most important, we know that that could be one of the greatest blessings that others will see. So help us not to be timid, Lord. You did not give us a spirit of timidity. You gave us a spirit of strength and of power to go out and be Christ in the world to others. That through our good works, they would see you and glorify your name in heaven. Hear our prayers this morning for renewed opportunities, for fresh opportunities to serve you as your church. Lord, whatever other needs that we have, we now lay them at your feet. And together we pray the words that you have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Morning on All Saints Day, I would like to speak to us, speak to the living, to consider the legacy that we will leave one day. And to help us do that, I want us to look to Hebrews chapter 12. I'll be reading the first verse and following. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood. And you have forgotten that word of encouragement that addresses you as sons. My son, do not make light of the Lord's discipline, and do not lose heart when he rebukes you, because the Lord disciplines those he loves, and he punishes everyone he accepts as a son. Endure hardship as a discipline. God is treating you as sons. For what son is not disciplined by his father? If you are not disciplined, and everyone undergoes discipline, then you are illegitimate children and not true sons. Moreover, we have all had human fathers who disciplined us, and we respected them for it. How much more should we submit to the Father of our spirits and live? Our fathers disciplined us for a little while as they thought best, but God disciplines us for our good, that we may share in his holiness. No discipline seems pleasant at the time, but painful. Later on, however, it produces a harvest of righteousness and peace for those who have been trained by it. Therefore, strengthen your feeble arms and weak knees. Make level paths for your feet, so that the lame may not be disabled, but rather healed. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
It's not always easy to put God first, to live the way that God wants us to live, to do what God wants us to do instead of what our friends might want us to do. It's not always easy to make time for worship and to pray, to read our Bibles every day. It's not always easy to tell others about our faith. Some time ago, our family decided to run a 5K. I knew the fellas would forge ahead, so I just kept huffing and puffing and enduring to the end as the cones started being picked up behind me. While resting, to my surprise, I heard someone call out my name, "Sherry, you won the trophy for your division." Little did I know I was the only one in that division. The race isn't easy. It's not for the faint-hearted. Faithful living is a series of choices and decisions, commitments, and change that can move us toward God. Faithful living is edgy and unpredictable, adventuresome and scary sometimes. That's why God has given us the church. Those that surround us that love and worship Him. So that we may love and encourage others. So that we may strengthen or help others to live in accountability with one another. In our reading today, after all that Christ has done for us, the writer of Hebrews says in verse 12, "Therefore, you strengthen your feeble arms and weak knees. Make paths level for your feet so that the lame may not be disabled, but rather healed." We are there for one another. We may move forward in faith as we love and worship God together by upholding His church with our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness. Faithful living is intentional and focused. And yes, there will be hardships. God uses these times to draw near to Him, bringing His comfort and peace as our faith is being perfected. He disciplines us. And as He does, God keeps His promises as we experience His gifts of joy and peace along the way. But Hebrews 12:1 tells us to strip off every weight that slows us down, especially the sin that so easily trips us up. Our sin becomes a stumbling block to drawing near to God and developing our full potential in Christ. You know that Satan will try to come up with 1,000 ways to trip us up, to entangle us, and get us into something that will prevent us from doing God's best. If we want to do what God has called us to do, then we must stay focused. Verse 2 tells us, "Let us fix our gaze. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith." If we want to do what God has called us to do, then we must stay focused, because the world we live in is filled with distractions and entanglements. And we are to keep our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. And Hebrews 12 reminds us that we have a great cloud of witnesses, people from every time and place who by faith live the way God wanted them to. We can learn from their lives how to be faithful to God. I challenge you to read Hebrews 11 about the great examples of faith. By faith, Abel. By faith, Enoch. By faith, Noah. By faith, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, and Moses. By faith, the people of Israel, and so many more. Faithful ones who have gone before us. You can name so many others that you have known. They all speak to us by their example of faith. We all have in common these ancestors in the faith that continue to speak to us today. May our lives also speak of faithful living, so that others may know the love of God for them. We aren't alone. With God's presence and the Holy Spirit to come alongside, the gift of the church, the body of Christ, and the witness of countless others, we can live faithfully for God. So what kind of legacy will you pass on? The most important legacy we will ever give to our children and our children's children is a life of faith. Our love and faithfulness to God and our love for one another. We can be saints too. That's the good news. Will you bow with me as we pray together? We give you thanks, O God, for all the saints who have worshiped you, whether in tabernacles or temples, in brush arbors or cathedrals, weathered wooden churches or crumbling cement buildings, houses, where your name was lifted and adored. We give you thanks, O God, for the hands lifted in praise. Manicured hands, and hands stained with grease or soil, strong hands and those gnarled with age, holy hands used as wave offerings across the land. We thank you, God, for hard-working saints, whether hard-hatted or steel-booted, head-ragged or aproned, blue-collared or three-piece suited. They left their mark on earth for you, for us, for our children to come. Thank you, God, for the tremendous sacrifices made by those who have gone before us. And most of all, for the sacrifice of your dear Son for the redemption of the world. May we learn how to walk wisely from their examples of faith, dedication, and worship. Empower us as witnesses of your love and grace, and kindle in us the desire to reflect Jesus to everyone we meet. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. At this time, we're going to enter into our time of communion for all the saints. Let us worship him together as we honor him and all that he has done for us in offering ourselves to him. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, God of Abraham and Sarah, God of Miriam and Moses, God of Joshua and Deborah, God of Ruth and David, God of the priest and the prophets, God of Mary and Joseph, God of the apostles and the martyrs, God of our mothers and our fathers, God of our children to all generations. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us. As we proclaim the mystery of faith,
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Pour your Holy Spirit on all of us here and on these gifts of bread and wine, and make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. Renew our communion with all your saints, especially those that have been named before you this morning. Since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, strengthen us to run with perseverance the race that has been set before us, looking to Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.